different. How innocent the video games world seemed at the start of the 90s. Japanese developers ruled the console roost, gamers hadn't started calling each other gay on the internet, and Nintendo and Sega cheerily tussled for supremacy. Blue skies, not Blu-ray. When Sega asked one of its development teams to come up with an icon to rival Nintendo's Mario, one of the powerhouse studios of the decade was born. And Sonic Team released Sonic the Hedgehog in the summer of 1991. Cue lots of excitement, shouting, and angry fanboy baiting. That's more like it. At an event in London earlier this week, there was a rare opportunity to take stock of Sonic and Sonic Team past, present, and future. Yuji Naka, as co-creator of the character and former head of Sonic Team, is the man credited with turning the Hedgehog into a global gaming phenomenon, as well as producing revered Sega classics like Knights and Phantasy Star Online. He quit Sega in 2006 to form a new studio, Propay. And if Sonic's reputation was on the slide then, it has since fallen off a cliff and landed snout first in a sewer. However, one of the men responsible for keeping the Sonic dream and Sonic Team alive is Tetsu Kitano. Kitano worked under Naka-san on Knights and Sonic's still controversial evolution to 3D in Sonic Adventures 1 and 2. And more recently, he worked on what you might say was the last genuinely good Sonic game for home consoles, Sonic and the Secret Rings on Wii. So we'll be taking a look at life with Sonic, but before that, let's consider life after Sonic.
Well, so far we've had lots of creative use of the Wiimote, all the way from using it as a steering wheel, a fishing rod and a tennis racket to just accidentally throwing it through your TV set. But until now, it's always depended on you actually holding the controller in your hand. But thanks to the creator of Sonic the Hedgehog, Yuji Naka, that's all changing. For his latest game, Let's Tap, all you need to do is take the controller, stick it on a box in front of you, and bash one out.
Freed from his Sonic shackles, Naka-san's first post-Sega releases are exclusive to Wii. Let's Tap is the first one heading westwards, jumping onto the money-spinning accessibility bandwagon that has developers desperate to get on board. Sega somewhat disingenuously describes Let's Tap as the world's first controller-free game. It isn't, because it relies on the controller picking up the vibrations of your tapping. But it is the first ever hands-free Wii game that we can think of, and no doubt a very clever new way to exploit the ever-versatile Wiimote. In Japan, the game released with a fold-out cardboard box that you assemble before placing the controller on top. Sega's London team improvised by giving us boxes of tissues. If Blue Peter made video games.
Let's
Tap features 5 minigames. Tap Runner is a bit like playing track and field on a table. Rhythm Tap is a fairly standard beat matching game that reads the strength of your taps. Silent Blocks, meanwhile, is a puzzle game that operates like a cross between Jenga and EA's Boom Blocks. And Bubble Voyager is a character-led race through mine-filled mazes. Finally, there's Visualizer, which is Let's Tap's chill-out zone, allowing you to create stuff like fireworks and massive splats of paint just by punching a table. People have won the Turner Prize for less. Let's Catch is Propay's other title that came out in Japan last Christmas. There are no plans to bring this to the West, but Naka-san confirms he is having a good fiddle with the upcoming Motion Plus accessory, designed to increase the sensitivity and accuracy of the Wiimote.
そうですね、 Wii リモートプラス自体はまた今の Wii リモコンよりもさらに細かいデータが取れますので非常に注目はしていますし、それもテストもさせていただいています。もしうまくそこのところが面白い、ゲームの発想とつながれば使ってゲームを作るんじゃないかと思いますが、まだ現時点ではやってないですね。
So is Mr. Sonic now Mr. Casual Games?You can't blame a new studio for following the money on Wii, but it should come as no surprise that Naka-san is also working in secret on a bigger project, featuring a new gaming hero. Here we go again.
そうですね。プロペっていう会社を作ってからですね、新しいゲームの形を出すっていうことと共にですね、新しいゲームキャラクターを作るっていうものも目指して頑張っていますので、で現時点ではまたそういったタイトルもいろいろ試行錯誤してやっているところですので、うまく出来上がってくれば皆さんにお見せする瞬間が来るんじゃないかなと思っています。
We're definitely fans of Let's Tap, and you can find out exactly why by hitting the red button to read our full review. The game's due out in Europe this summer. Now, before we find out Naka-san's views on what Sega have done with his hedgehog, let's take a look at Sonic's latest adventure.
Let's face it, there have been some really rubbish Sonic games over the last few years, and mainly the problem's been gimmicks.Like the guns in Shadow the Hedgehog and the Werehog in Sonic Unleashed. Now, the new Sonic game, Sonic and the Black Knight, features a sword, which, yes, is a gimmick, but the game's also by the team that brought us Sonic and the Secret Rings on Wii, which was actually pretty good. We're in London to speak to the Sonic team to tell us why, again, we've got a Sonic game we can get excited about.
The reason for Sonic's sword play is the setting of Black Knight.After the Arabian Nights of Secret Rings, we're now thrust, literally, into the legend of King Arthur. Kitano-san knows what a beating Sonic games have taken in recent years for introducing needless nonsense. But he insists that the sword is mightier than the gimmick. And based on Secret Rings, he deserves the benefit of the doubt.
そういう意見ももちろん目を通してますし、我々自身も、そんなの持たない方が良かったよっていうふうに言われないようには、絶対しなければいけないっていうふうには思ってゲームを作ってます。
Taking a cue from Sonic Unleashed, thankfully not one involving a werehog, Black Knight blends 3D action with the occasional switch of perspective to old school 2D gameplay. Any chance of another pure 2D Sonic experience being made?
ではいないですね。やっぱりソニックのメインターゲットの、ユーザーの多いところっていうのを狙っていきたいなというふうには思ってますけれども、今後考えていきたいと思います。
Now, showing off your new game to a room of grubby journalists is one thing. Showing it off in front of your old boss and the man who created Sonic the Hedgehog is another thing entirely. But Kitano-san takes it all in his stride.
ないです。
Now, come on, Yuji Naka. What do you really think of all these Sonic games you've had nothing to do with?
そうですね。ソニック自体は僕15年間育ててきて、今は新しいソニックが、ブラックナイトでしたっけ、出てますけど、そういう意味では僕が作り上げたソニックチームっていう、クリエイター集団が今も頑張って仕事をしてくれてるので、それはそれで嬉しいなと。特に、ソニック僕は多分セガにずっといるとソニックをまだずっと作り続けないといけないと思うんですが、そういう意味では新しく今回プロペっていうのを作って、またニューキャラクターだったりニューゲームっていうのを作れるその場所が作れたので、そういう意味では何ですかね、頑張ってくれてるし自分もまた新しいものができるっていうので、すごくそういう意味ではハッピーな感じだと思いますけども。
Really? Did you play the Werehog? Or that 2006 abomination?
それに多分僕がまだずっとソニックを作っていると、僕の枠からソニックが出れなくなってしまう可能性のが大きいので、そういう意味ではそれを、ソニックが飛び出ていくことが可能になるじゃないですか。それはそれで、ソニックにとっても楽しめるんじゃないかと思いますし、そのソニックのファンの人たちもその新しいソニックのところをまた楽しんでもらえると、よりこう広がっていっていいんじゃないかなと思いますけども。
Well, if not quite recapturing the full glories of old, it's so far so good on Wii at least. And Sonic and the Black Knight is out exclusively on the platform next month. So for Naka-san, the future's bright, but not necessarily blue. Anyone who can rock that tie and hanky combo is okay by us. Naka-san, we salute you.